Welcome to Bala Sir's YouTube channel. Before seeing the video, subscribe my YouTube channel and press the red button. Today we will learn chapter 3, chemical reaction and equation for class 10. Welcome students. So today we will learn the types of chemical reaction. Now there are 4 types of chemical reaction. The first type is combination reaction, second type is decomposition reaction, third type is displacement reaction, and fourth is your double displacement reaction. Now let us learn each reaction one by one in detail. Your first type of chemical reaction is combination reaction. What do you mean by combination reaction? When two or more reactants combine in a reaction to form a single product, we call this as a combination reaction. Let's say for example, let us take two or more reactants, A plus B. These are the two reactants. But when these two reactants combine, they will form a single product. So this A and B are combined here to form a single product. On the left side there are two reactants, but on the right side there is only one product. We call this type of reaction as combination reaction. That means two reactants combine to form a single product. We call this as a combination reaction. Let us take some example by some equation. NH3 is ammonia, HCl is hydrochloric acid, it forms NHCl, NH4Cl, which is the ammonium chloride. Ammonia, HCl and ammonium chloride. You take a small amount of hydrochloric acid in a test tube, heat the test tube. Now dip a glass rod in the ammonia solution and hold on the top of the test tube. So when you heat the test tube, a smoke will come from the test tube, which is of HCl. So when you dip the ammonia, a rod in the ammonia, and in the test, near the test tube, you bring the rod, the gas which comes out from the HCl, you will observe a white smoke coming from the tip of the glass rod, and that is the ammonium chloride. So due to heating, your HCl vapor starts coming out from the test tube and ammonia gas comes out from the solution on the glass rod. The ammonia gas and the hydrogen chloride gas react, both the react to form a salt of ammonium chloride in a gaseous state first, but immediately due to the condensation process at room temperature, it got transformed into a solid state. As a result, a white smoke was formed and this is the chemical reaction. Let's take another example, magnesium strip, 2Mg plus O2. These are the two different reactants. It forms 2MgO, combination reaction. One more example, CaO, calcium oxide plus water. What is formed? Calcium hydroxide plus heat. You can see it is balanced, CaCa, 1 Ca, 2 oxygen, 2 hydrogen. So 2 oxygen, 2 hydrogen, I made it combined. It is calcium hydroxide. So this is the example of your combination reaction. We can write some more examples also. Decomposition reaction. This is the total opposite of combination reaction. The definition is as follows. The chemical reaction in which two or more products are formed from a single reactant. Let's say for example, a single reactant is your AB. AB is your single reactant. Now, after the reaction, A and B, it splits into two parts. That is A plus B. That means this is your product. So according to this, the chemical reaction in which two or more products. So two or more products are formed from a single reactant. We call this as decomposition reaction. Let's take some example. C12L, H22 and O11. It gives 12 carbon plus 11 H2O. Now, you know what do you mean by this C12, H22, O11? It is sugar. You know, when you heat a sugar, a carbon is left behind it. And when you try to heat the sugar, from that sugar, a water comes out. And after some time, you see a black color carbon. So, here carbon is obtained separately and water is released out. So, when you heat a sugar, carbon is formed and water is separated. So here, this is called as a decomposition reaction. Just see.
Sugar will cause a chemical reaction. Let's take that off there. So that when this goes horribly wrong.
Alrighty.
I know that it's not salt.
I mean, sugar.
Yeah, check it out.
But cool. It's not black.
Yep, you can actually see the vapors coming up out of it.
Yeah, you can.
Try to make sure you don't tilt it. I don't want it to fall in there and gum up our stove. Wow, check that out.
Spoon that on fire?
No. It's kind of what happens when you're cooking a marshmallow and you keep it in too hot, isn't it? Look at that go.
That's so cool.
So when sugar is heated, a black carbon is left behind and water is released.
No.
You can see the video.
I really want to bubble over and do that. Yeah. Okay. Whoa. Hold on there. Okay. Well, that's fine if it does it right there.
Sorry.
Guess I can turn that off. Huh?
That's what I wanted to see. Did you get this?
Yes, cool. Sir.
Let's take another reaction of decomposition reaction. If you take calcium carbonate, which is a solid, you have to heat the calcium carbonate. So heating, I put a triangle sign. When you heat a calcium carbonate, calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide is formed. Now there is one experiment in which we call it as decomposition of calcium carbonate, in which if you take a test tube which contains CaCO3, and when you heat it, after heating it, this is a pipe. You take one more test tube in which there is a lime water in it. So when you heat the calcium carbonate, a calcium oxide is remained down, but a carbon dioxide comes out. The carbon dioxide comes out through this bent tube and goes through the another test tube which has a lime water. When carbon dioxide mixed with the lime water, this lime water will turn milky. This lime water will turn milky because of carbon dioxide. So this is called as a decomposition reaction. We'll take one more off. H2H2O2. That gives 2H2O plus oxygen. Now 2H2O is nothing but a hydrogen peroxide. Now this hydrogen peroxide you have seen when you go to the clinic, when you are wounded, somewhere a wound in your body. So doctor used to clean it using some solution. That is the hydrogen peroxide solution. He take a cotton mix, take hydrogen peroxide in the cotton and he clean the wound. So that white color solution which looks like a water, that is the hydrogen peroxide. So when the hydrogen peroxide comes out, it becomes water and oxygen is released out. So that means a single reactant is formed, a single reactant will form two different products. So this is a decomposition reaction. Displacement reaction. Now, what do you mean by displacement reaction? The reaction in which the place of the ion of a less reactive element in a compound is taken by another more reactive element by formation of its own ion. Let's say, for an example, I'll take A and B. A is plus, B is minus, plus C. Now here, what you observe is AB plus C. Now what will be here? Now B will be taken by C. So it becomes B CB plus A. That means, according to this, the reaction in which the place of an ion, that is, of a less reactive element in a compound, is taken by another more reactive element by formation of its own ion. Now this C, which is more reactive, it removes that A, and in place of A, C will be in that place of A, because C is more reactive and A is less reactive. So less reactive element in a compound is taken by another more reactive element. So just see here, B is in its place, but C comes here and A goes there. That means they both exchange the position, because C is more reactive and A is less reactive. Let us take some example. Copper sulfate, which is an aqueous solution, plus iron, which is a solid. Here in this equation, iron is more reactive than copper. So what will happen? Iron will replace copper. So if I remove this Cu and put Fe, what it will be? FeSO4 plus the Cu will come in place of Fe. That means why this happens? Because Fe is more reactive and Cu is less reactive. So more reactive element is taken by the less reactive element. That means the reaction in which the place of ion of a less reactive element in a compound is taken by the another more reactive element by the formation of its own ion.
Reaction of iron nails with copper sulfate solution. In this module, you will learn about the reaction of iron nails with copper sulfate solution. When an iron object is kept in copper sulfate solution, the color of the object and the copper sulfate solution changes. Let us perform an activity to find out the details of this color change. For this activity, you will require iron nails, sandpaper, test tubes, copper sulfate solution, thread, clamp stand, and test tube stand. Take two test tubes marked as A and B, and in each test tube pour about 10 milliliter of copper sulfate solution. Fix test tube A on the clamp stand and keep the test tube B as control sample in test tube stand. Now, take three iron nails and clean them by rubbing with sandpaper. Tie two iron nails with a thread and immerse them carefully in the copper sulfate solution in test tube A for about 20 minutes and keep the third nail aside. After 20 minutes, take out the nails and keep them beside the unused clean nail. Do you observe any change? On comparing both the nails with the unused nail, you will find that the iron nails, which are kept in the copper sulfate solution, have developed a reddish-brown layer on them. Now, take out the test tube A from the clamp stand and keep it beside test tube B for comparison. On comparing both the solutions, you will find that the original deep blue color of the copper sulfate solution has faded away. What is the reason behind these changes? When iron nails are dipped in copper sulfate solution, the iron metal reacts with copper sulfate, which results in the formation of ferrous sulfate and copper metal. In this reaction, iron, being more reactive than copper, displaces copper from the copper sulfate solution and forms ferrous sulfate, which fades the deep blue color of the solution. The displaced copper then deposits on the iron nails in the form of a reddish brown coating. Since in this reaction, a more reactive metal iron displaces a less reactive metal copper from its compound, it's a displacement reaction. In this module, you have learnt that iron metal displaces copper from its compound copper sulfate and forms iron sulfate along with copper metal. This reaction is a displacement reaction.
Let's take one more example. CuSO4 plus lead, Pb. Pb is lead. So PbSO4 plus Cu. Let's take one more example. CuSO4 plus zinc. Zinc is more reactive than copper. It becomes ZnSO4 plus copper. So this is called as a displacement reaction. Double displacement reaction. The reaction in which the ion in the reactants are exchanged to form a precipitate are called double displacement reaction. Let's say, for example, A B plus C D. A is plus, D is minus, C is plus, D is minus. Now in double displacement, both of them exchange their negative ions. That means the reaction in which the ions in the reactants are exchanged. So in place of B, D will come, and in place of D, B will come. There is no exchange in the positive ion, there is only exchange in the negative ion. So this will become AD plus CB. This is called as double displacement reaction. Let us take some example of a double displacement reaction in which barium sulfate plus potassium dichromate, potassium chromate, barium sulfate plus potassium sulfate. Here Ba is plus, SO4 is minus, K2 is plus, CrO4 is minus. So what will exchange? In place of SO4, this will be CrO4 will come. So these both will exchange their position. So Ba, then here CrO4 plus K2SO4. So here the ions are exchanged to form a double displacement reaction. Now the activity is given in this barium sulfate and potassium chromate, in which in page number 38 it's given. Always remember, whenever double displacement is there, a precipitate is formed. Always in double displacement, compulsory a precipitate is formed. Now here, what is the precipitate formed? Now the precipitate formed, I'll put an arrow here. So we'll put a down arrow. This barium chromate, barium chromate is a precipitate. And what is the color of the precipitate? The color of the precipitate is yellow. The precipitate which you obtain is yellow. Then next question is, write the balanced equation. So you have to write this equation and you have to balance it. So what type of displacement is this? Double displacement reaction. So what is this? Potassium sulfate. So this is the best and good example of double displacement reaction, endothermic and exothermic reaction. Now endothermic reaction, endo means heat is gained, that is heat is absorbed. Now let me give you some example. You take a ice means it is very cold. When you keep the ice outside, what will happen? The outside heat is absorbed by the ice and the ice, it starts melting. But why the ice starts melting? It is because of the heat. That means ice plus heat, it's the ice melts. In the reactant side, when we add heat, it is endothermic. That means here heat is absorbed. So wherever heat is absorbed, we call this as an endothermic process. Let's take one more example. Dissolution of potassium nitrate in water. When potassium nitrate, you add water in it, heat, because of the heat, the potassium nitrate dissolves. We call this as endothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction is opposite of this. Here heat is lost. Let's say for example, a ice which is already formed, which is formation of ice. Now here what will happen? The ice which you take it from the freezer, here the ice which you take it from the freezer, because of heat the ice melts. But now the ice is formed. Why? Because when you keep this ice cube in the freezer, what will happen? All the heat from that ice, that is from the water, let's say water, you take a water and keep it in a freezer, all the heat from the water is lost. So that means when heat is lost, ice is formed. So if I say water, if you keep it in a refrigerator, ice is formed plus heat is lost. So here I'll write heat. By why? Because here heat is given away, heat is lost. Here the heat should be written in the product side. If heat is written in the product side, that means heat is lost, heat is given away. But heat is written in the reactant side, that means heat is absorbed. Let's take some more example of endothermic and exothermic reaction. If I take potassium nitrate, I add water in it. When I add water in it, due to heat, it dissolves and form potassium nitrate. Potassium nitrate, if I add water in it, due to heat which is in the atmosphere, it dissolves and become potassium nitrate. That means heat is given on the left side, here heat is observed here. Since heat is in the reactant side, it is endothermic reaction. One more example I'll take, calcium carbonate. Now this calcium carbonate, I first heat it in the presence of oxygen. When I heat this, it becomes CaO plus carbon dioxide gas. This is also endothermic reaction, because whatever you heat it, either in the presence of oxygen or using a gas, whatever you heat it, it is endothermic reaction, because you heat means heat is absorbed in that reaction. So these are the two examples of endothermic reaction. I'll take the example of the exothermic reaction. In exothermic reaction, the heat should be on the product side. Let's take calcium oxide. I add water in it. As soon as I add water in it, here the heat which is in that calcium oxide is lost and it becomes calcium hydroxide. And the heat is lost. One more example of this exothermic I'll tell you. You take any like Surf Excel, Ariel, any washing powder, keep it in your hand. When you keep the washing powder in your hand, you see a light heatness in that Surf Excel or Ariel, whatever washing powder you use it, you feel a light heatness. When you add water in that, the heat goes out. The heat is lost. So that is the exothermic reaction. Washing powder is on the reactant part. So when you add water in it, the heat is lost. So that is the best example of an exothermic reaction. I'll take one more reaction. Sodium hydroxide. When you touch the sodium hydroxide, you feel some heatness in that sodium hydroxide. But as soon as you add water in it, the heatness is lost. That means NaOH, it is NaOH, but heat is lost. So I think it is very clear what do you mean by endothermic and what do you mean by exothermic.